Hello everyone! This is the official character creation guide for the Cloudbreaker Alliance tabletop RPG. To play Cloudbreaker Alliance, the players need to assume the role of a player character. And there are three ways you can create your own character. The first and simplest method is to pick one out of the 8 pre-made characters and give the character a name. The second method is to pick a pre-made character and modify the character to your liking as you go through the complete character creation process. The last method, which is also the standard method, is to create your own character from scratch by going through the complete character creation process with an empty character sheet. Character sheets are used to record all your character's game-related information. You can find the character sheets of the 8 pre-made characters and empty character sheets at the back of the core rulebook. They are also packaged with the PDF file of the book if you bought it digitally. You can also download the character sheets from our website or from the link in the description below if you're watching this video on YouTube. The complete character creation process has 4 main steps. If you're building your character while watching this video, feel free to pause when necessary. In step 1, you choose your character's life form, character quirks, and class. These are the most important choices you can make for your character. Life form is something your character can't really change. Character quirks can be modified slowly, and classes can be easily swapped once you gain rank in them. Their combination is the narrative core of your character. Step 1A. Choose a life form. The short list of your character's life forms is on page 27 of the core rulebook. When you have selected your life form, you get all the related life form traits. For this sample character, I have chosen the orc, so he gets the hardy and explosive voice traits. You can find detailed information regarding these life forms and their traits in Chapter 5 in the respective life form section. There's also the option to create a custom life form by mixing and matching existing traits. You start with 3 trait points. You can spend 2 points to gain a major trait and spend 1 point to gain a minor trait. You can get extra traits such as small for free. Step 1B. Use 2 quirk points to rank up your character's quirks. You have 2 quirk points that you can put into the list of existing character quirks. The short list is in page 28, and the detailed information is in chapter 6. Each point you put into a character quirk increases its rank by 1, and you can use the related subquirk of that rank. For example, if you spend 2 points in the adventurous character quirk, you get the Explorer Rank 1 subquirk and Peak Performance Rank 2 subquirk. You're encouraged to pick 2 separate quirks to build a more rounded character, but you don't have to do that. The Cheat at Life and Cheat Fate quirks are special. Each of them cost 2 points to rank. Step 1C. Gain 1 class rank under a basic discipline. Your character starts at level 1 and can gain 1 rank in one of your chosen basic classes, making it your primary class until you change it. The short list of classes is on page 28, and the detailed information is in chapter 7 in the respective discipline section. A class is a subset of a discipline. You gain rank in the class, not the discipline. When you reach a certain rank in a class, you get not only the class features, but also the discipline features of the corresponding class rank. For example, when the sample character has 1 rank in the Ranger class, which is under the Soldier discipline, the character gets the Scout Operative Ranger class feature and the Weapon Drill discipline feature. Don't forget to write down your discipline's combat masteries too. The soldier has weapon mastery in light, medium, and heavy weapons, armor mastery in light and medium armors, and maneuver masteries in scuffle and cheap shot. Step 2A. Determine item slot number. This is the amount of items you can carry. All characters start with 8 item slots, but it can be raised by the relevant life form traits, such as the orc's hardy trait, which gives the character 2 additional item slots, raising the total to 10. Step 2B. Cred and starting items. You start with 200 creds, the currency used by the Cloudbreaker Alliance. You can use them to buy any items and equipment a copper-grade Cloudbreaker can buy. You can find the list of purchasable items in Chapter 9. If you can't decide on what to get, then you can refer to the Suggested Starting Items section of your chosen class under your discipline in Chapter 7. For this sample character, I just copied the suggested ranger items. Step 3A. Determine your 4 attributes. You have a total of 7 points you can allocate to your character's attributes. So, I place 3 points to the sample character's strength, 1 to agility, 1 to awareness, and 2 to empathy. At character creation, you can only reach a maximum of 3 on any attribute. But, as you gain level and your attribute total increases, you can raise the attribute to a maximum of 5. Attributes are only used for task roles and non-combat problem solving, so you don't have to worry about not dealing enough damage by putting points into your empathy. Step 3B. Pick 2 skill masteries. At level 1, your mastery bonus is 2. It will increase as you level up, but let's not worry about that for now. Among the list of 12 skills in the character sheet, you can choose 2 skills to have mastery in. Having mastery in a skill allows you to add your mastery bonus to your attribute when rolling for the relevant skill to solve tasks. Since this sample character has 2 in empathy and mastery in artistry, the total artistry skill bonus is 2 plus 2, 4, and we calculate the rest accordingly. Step 3C. Pick 1 toolkit mastery. Among the list of 8 standard toolkits in the character sheet, choose 1 toolkit to have mastery in. Your toolkit task roll bonus comes from the quality of your toolkit plus mastery bonus if you have mastery in the toolkit. This sample character has a basic mechanics kit with 3 points in quality. The character also has mastery in mechanics kit, so 3 plus 2, the total bonus is 5. Step 4 is the final stretch. Here, we just calculate all the secondary stats derived from the options made above. Step 4A. HP, Resolve, Movement, Defense, and Fortitudes. Hit points. Your base hit points maximum is 15. If you're wearing an armor type you have mastery in, then you can add the armor's hit points bonus to your maximum. Since the sample character wears a thick hide medium armor and has mastery in it, it gives the character's hit point maximum 13 bonus points, making the total 28. A different rule applies to characters with unarmored toughness mastery, such as those from the martial artist and brute disciplines. While not wearing armor, they start with 20 maximum hit points. You can refer to the unarmored toughness's HP growth in the leveling up chart on page 32. Resolve. All characters have 30 maximum resolve at level 1. Your turn speed and movement range come from your class's discipline statistics. Since the sample character is a ranger, I just look at the soldier discipline's stats. Your defense, physical fortitude, and mental fortitude also come from the same section. It's the number here plus your current mastery, which is 2 at level 1. So the sample character has 8 defense, 7 physical fortitude, and also 7 mental fortitude. This means that as you level up, these stats will increase according to your mastery. Step 4B, Elemental Attunements and MP. Your Mind Points, or MP, start at 15, and for each attunement slot that you have, add 10 points to it. For example, if my character is a Spellweaver Arcanist, I would have 2 attunement slots from the Discipline feature, giving me an additional 20 MP, making the total 35. But since this character doesn't have any attunement slots, his MP remains at 15. If your character is a spellcaster, you can use your attunement slots to attune to elements. If you are from the Arcanist discipline, you can attune to arcane elements by using 1 slot for each element. If you are a thaumaturgist, you can attune to cosmic elements for 2 slots each. When you are attuned to an element, you can cast all the spells of that element. For example, an arcanist attuned to fire and wind elements can cast Flame Arrow, Flame Weapon, Circle of Fire, Wind Shear, Ventomancy, Tailwind, and the combined fire and wind spell, Fire Blast. Step 4C, Actions, Attacks, and Effects. As a level 1 character, you only have 1 major action and 1 minor action during a critical situation. You can use the space to the right to note down the attacks and effects of your weapons and spells. You don't have to note down everything, just the ones that you commonly use as a reminder. Write down the name, range, combat roll bonus, and the damage it deals. If you have mastery in the weapon, such as the sample character having mastery in light weapons such as short swords, you can add the mastery bonus, 2, to the bonus column. If the weapon provides you with an additional combat roll bonus, like rapiers, then obviously you can add that. Well, that's it! You have completed the character creation process. For the finishing touches, you can name the character and give your character backstories and long and short-term goals. Talk to your game master to know what would be appropriate. By the way, here's a quick advice on creating your character's backstory. It's not the events that define the characters, it's their reaction. Let's say that 3 children were orphaned when their village was destroyed by monsters. The first child develops a trauma for monsters. The second becomes a monster hunter. And the third becomes a jokester because he learned to tell jokes as a coping mechanism. Can you see the difference? If you haven't already owned Cloudbreaker Alliance, you can go buy the game from the links below. Also, subscribe to the channel because we will be releasing more in-depth videos in the future.